Hello friends, I am Dr. Ashish Agrawat. Welcome to my channel, Live Biochemistry. Today, I am going to discuss about the acid-base balance part 2. And in this lecture, I am going to talk about the respiratory acidosis, metabolic acidosis, respiratory alkalosis, metabolic alkalosis, with their cause and explanation, and anion gap, high anion gap and normal anion gap. And this will be very easy. I will try to make it very easy. As such, it is a very complex topic. So stay tuned and watch this video till the end. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to my channel. And now I am sharing the screen with you. So to understand the acid-base balance and different type of acidosis and alkalosis, first we have to again revise about the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. Okay. So if acid ionizes, it is converted to H plus and A minus. So what will be the ionic constant? It will be hydrogen ion concentration, cation, anion upon the acid. If you want to make the hydrogen ion concentration, that means it is Ka into Ha upon A minus. Now we know pH is equal to logarithm of hydrogen ion. So what will be the pH? Minus log upon Ka into Ha and A, okay, acid upon base, right? So you can write it like log Ka, and here when we add log to both the side, here it will be plus, but here as a negative, so I have to write minus log Ha acid upon base. Clear? Now you can write it as a pKa, like pH is negative logarithm of H plus. Here there is a pKa, and if there is a minus, and if we reverse it, numerator and denominator, then you can write it as like log, okay, upon base upon acid. Okay, so this is the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. Okay, so we have seen about how it is derived. This is very important to learn about the basics of respiratory acidosis and alkalosis. So if we have a bicarbonate buffer, so major extracellular buffer, so what will be the base? Base will be the bicarbonate. And what will be the acid is H2CO3. That we know. Now we know the pKa of this bicarbonate buffer is 6.1. Now the concentration of bicarbonate ion is 24 milliequivalent per liter. And concentration of H2CO3 is 1.2 milliequivalent per liter. Now how this 1.2 is derived? Because CO2 normal level is 40 millimercury, and solubility coefficient of CO2 is 0.03. If you multiply 40 into 0.03, it will come as a 1.2. Right. So carbonic acid concentration is 1.2 and bicarbonate ion is 24. This is normal. So 6.1 plus log of 24 upon 1.2 is log of 20. That means 6.1 and log 20 is 1.3. That's why our normal body pH is 7.4. So there is a balance between the bicarbonate and carbonic acid, right? And if this balance disturb, there is an imbalance occur, and it will lead to the different type of acidosis and alkalosis. So here, suppose pH, okay, if it is less than 7.35, it is called as a acidosis, and if it is more than 7.45, it is called as a alkalosis. This is clear. Now this acidosis has a two component. One is respiratory acidosis, or it may be the metabolic acidosis. Okay. And in alkalosis, it may be again, it will be respiratory alkalosis or metabolic alkalosis. Now we will see about the respiratory acidosis. So respiratory acidosis, mainly the carbonic acid portion will be affected. And in metabolic, mainly the bicarbonate level is affected. So what will happen in respiratory acidosis? So in case of respiratory acidosis. So as we know, there is acidosis means pH is less than 7.35. This 7.35 less than 7.35 is because of the H2CO3 level. Okay, that will be increased. So if we see the equation, pH is equal to pKa plus log of bicarbonate upon H2CO3. We know normal level bicarbonate is 24 and here it is 1.2. So if any condition that will lead to increase H2CO3, why H2CO3 will increase? When there is CO2 will increase. When CO2 will increase? When condition like obstructive disease of lung, COPD, chronic asthma, okay, or chest injury, muscle injury, or paralysis of chest muscle, like in case of poliomyelitis, okay, or patient in the narcotic, okay, where CO2 center is depressed. So all this will condition will lead to increase CO2. Increase CO2 will turn increase H2CO3. If we suppose pKa is 6.1, if it's fixed, bicarbonate is 24, and if H2CO3 is increased from 1.2 to 2.4, it is double. Suppose, okay, for better calculation, I have made this as a 2.4. But suppose it is increased, so what will happen? 24 divided by the 2.4, okay, this is log. So 6.1 plus log of 10, log of 10 is 1, that is 7.1. So you can see the pH is decreased, okay, and because of the increase in H2CO3. The increase in H2CO3 is because of this COPD, asthma, paralysis, muscle injury, chest injury, okay, narcotic, CNS depression. So all will lead to the accumulation of CO2, that will lead to increase H2CO3. As H2CO3 will be increased, the pH will be decreased. That is called as a respiratory acidosis. Clear. Now coming to the metabolic acidosis. Here, as we know, metabolic, that means bicarbonate component will be affected. So now what is pH? pH is equal to pKa plus log of bicarbonate upon H2CO3. So when this H2CO3 will increase, that will lead to the decrease in pH, and that is respiratory acidosis. When this bicarbonate level that will be decreased, it will lead to the metabolic acidosis. So when this bicarbonate level is decreased, whenever there is an acidic substance in the blood is increased, you neutralize that bicarbonate buffer is utilized, and therefore HCO3 level will be decreased. So what are the conditions of high acidic, okay, substance like diabetic ketoacidosis? When beta hydroxybutyrate or acetoacetate, these different bodies level are increased, it will lead to the diabetic ketoacidosis, okay, or lactic acidosis. Okay, on this condition where there is an increased acidity, to neutralize that bicarbonate level is decreased. Or in case of renal failure. So what happens in renal failure? As the bicarbonate normal is absorbed, but because of the kidney failure, bicarbonate will be excreted in the urine. So bicarbonate level will be decreased, and that will lead to the metabolic acidosis. Okay, or the patient has an amino aciduria. So because of this acidic substance, it will lead to the decrease to neutralize that, and to maintain the pH, this bicarbonate level are utilized, and it will lead to the decrease in bicarbonate level. So suppose normal bicarbonate level is 24, H2CO3 is 1.2. Suppose bicarbonate is decreased from 24 to 12, it is decreased to 12, and carbonic acid is same. Okay, so pKa plus log of 12 upon 1.2, pKa is 6.1, log of 10, and the pH is 7.1. So you can see here pH is decreased, but because of the decrease in bicarbonate level, that is called as a metabolic acidosis. Now coming to the alkalosis. So alkalosis means pH is more than 7.4, right? So it may be due to the respiratory alkalosis or metabolic alkalosis. So now we know respiratory alkalosis, which component is affected? H2CO3. And when there is a decreased level of H2CO3, okay, so we see now pH is equal to pKa log of bicarbonate upon, this is a very important equation, okay, if you understand this, it is very easy now. So if bicarbonate is decreased, you can naturally see bicarbonate is decreased, that will lead to the increase in pH, okay. So if suppose pKa is 6.1, log of bicarbonate remains same, 24. But instead of 1.2, okay, normal level bicarbonate 24, HCl 1.2. Instead of 1.2, suppose it is 0.6. So what will happen? 6.1 plus log 40, and as we know, log 40 is around 1.6. So pH will be 7.7. pH is increased, that's why it is called alkalosis. And because H2CO3 is affected, it is decreased, it is called as a respiratory alkalosis. So now, which are the conditions that will lead to the decrease in H2CO3? So that in which CO2 is decreased, that will lead to the decrease in H2CO3. So why CO2 is decreased? Because of the hyperventilation. When person breathe out very fast and or hyperventilation, then CO2 will be expire out and it will lead to the decrease in CO2. So hyperventilation or a psychiatric disorder like hysteria or at the high altitude where there is an increased breathing, so all will lead to the respiratory alkalosis. So I hope it is clear. And the last condition is metabolic alkalosis. So as we know, so far now you know that bicarbonate will be affected, and what will happen? Bicarbonate pH is equal to pKa plus log of bicarbonate upon H2CO3. So a condition which will increase the bicarbonate level, it will increase the pH. How? Suppose pKa is 6.1, instead of 24 bicarbonate, suppose it is 48, increase to 48, H2CO3 is same. So what will happen? 6.1 plus log of 40 and 6.1 plus 1.6 log 40, that is 7.7. So this condition is called metabolic alkalosis. Now, which condition lead to increase bicarbonate level? Suppose there is a GI obstruction or in which vomiting occurs. So chloride is removed along with the H+. So as chloride is decreased, to maintain the neutrality, bicarbonate will come out and bicarbonate level will be increased. Okay, and if it is increased, it will lead to increase in pH. Or in case of ingestion of alkaline substance, it will lead to the metabolic alkalosis. So I hope this is now clear to you how this takes place. Okay. So in case of metabolic acidosis, so metabolic is, that means bicarbonate should be decreased. Okay. And whenever there is a, if you see, so this is very important. Okay, Hazelbaum Anderson equation. If you remember this, it will be very easy. So when bicarbonate level is decreased, okay, because of this diabetic mellitus or ketoacidosis or lactic acidosis or renal failure, okay, amino acid urea, all these conditions where bicarbonate is decreased, in that condition, we have to maintain the pH. Okay, suppose FCO3 from 24, it is reduced to 12. So what our body will do? Normal HCO3 is 1.2. Okay, but it is reduced to, suppose it is reduced to 0.6. So what will happen? This is 6.1. And plus log this ratio will be 20. 20 is 1.3. So pH is maintained. So to compensate for the metabolic acidosis, the respiratory portion will be activated and there will be hyperventilation. Okay, so in patient of diabetes, ketoacidosis, you will see that person breathing, respiratory rate is very increased. Okay, to compensate, to maintain the pH, because if pH is not maintained, it will lead to the decreased pH, will lead to the increased aqueous concentration, it will affect the enzyme, you will die if pH is less than 7. So to compensate, there will be hyperventilation. So CO2 will be decreased, so H2CO3 will be decreased and ratio is maintained and pH is maintained. Right? Same way, in case of metabolic alkalosis, the bicarbonate level will be increased. Okay, suppose instead of 24, it is 48. Okay, so to maintain this, what our body will do? H2CO3, instead of 1.2, it is increased to 2.4. Okay, and when this H2CO3 increase, when CO2 is increased, CO2 level in the blood is increased, when there will be hypoventilation. Okay, so decreased breathing rate, so CO2 will be accumulated and H2CO3 is increased, and so this ratio is maintained. Okay, and so that pH is maintained. So in case of metabolic component, your respiratory lung system will activated to compensate it. Now if we see the respiratory acidosis, so I will write here pH is equal to pKa log of bicarbonate upon H2CO3. So whenever there is a respiratory acidosis, that means pCO2 is increased. Suppose it is from 1.2, it has increased to 2.4. So what our body will do to maintain the pH, there will be increased reabsorption of bicarbonate. So instead of 24, bicarbonate level will be increased. Of course, 48. It will be log 20. So our pH is maintained. So 6.1 plus log 20 is 1.3. So pH is maintained. So in case of respiratory acidosis, metabolic portion means bicarbonate increase absorption. So kidney will work. Kidney will increase the reabsorption of bicarbonate. This is a compensation to maintain the pH. Or in case of decreased PCO2. So suppose instead of 1.2, it is 0.6. So in that condition, what will happen? There is a decreased reabsorption of bicarbonate and increased excretion of bicarbonate through urine. Okay, so instead of 24, it will be 12. So it will be log, it is 10.3, so log 20 is 1.3, so pH will be maintained. So I hope you understand this basic of this acid-base balance. Now we will see what are the cause of metabolic acidosis. So diabetic ketoacidosis, lactic ketoacidosis, renal tubular acidosis due to loss of bicarbonate ions only, renal failure, okay, amino acid urea, all this lead to the metabolic acidosis. Respiratory acidosis, so COPD, cardiac arrest, weakness of respiratory muscle like poliomyelitis or chest deformity, okay, or chest injury, or morphine, okay, narcotic drug that will lead to decrease, okay, respiratory center and accumulation of CO2, and as CO2 increase, H2CO2 increase, and there will be respiratory acidosis. Metabolic alkalosis, when there is a GI obstruction, there is a loss of fluoride, okay, and along with the H plus and administration of alkaline lead to metabolic alkalosis. Or respiratory alkalosis, when there is hyperventilation, hysteria, high altitude, or salicylate poisoning. Okay, so this is how respiratory acidosis, respiratory alkalosis, metabolic acidosis, and metabolic alkalosis. So I hope it is very clear to you now. Now I coming to the anion gap. This is also frequently asked in competitive exams or in theory exam. So anion gap may be the high anion gap or normal anion gap, or even low, rarely. So what is anion gap? It is the difference between cations and anions. Okay. This is occurred because of the unmeasured anions. Okay. So which are the anions which are not measured normally? So like proteins or phosphate or sulfate. Okay. Protein, phosphate, sulfate, or organic acid even. So all will lead to the unmeasured anion, and it is normally this difference is 10 to 12 okay, millimole. But in condition where there is a acidic condition in our body, in case of metabolic acidosis, like diabetic ketoacidosis or lactic acidosis or renal failure, what will happen? This bicarbonate will be utilized. So this is not there. So this ratio, this gap will be increased because sodium potassium chloride will not be affected. It will lead to the high anion gap. Okay, so condition like diabetes, ketoacidosis, lactic acidosis, or renal failure, okay, or amino acid urea, all will lead to the high anion gap. But in condition where there is a diarrhea, okay, or intestinal fistula, where along with the sodium chloride is also lost. So it will lead to the normal anion gap. Okay, so sodium and potassium and chloride all are lost. So ultimately the gap remains the same. That is called as a normal anion gap. Okay, 10 to 12. So here the cause like diarrhea, intestinal fistula, okay, these are the causes, or salicylate poisoning like that. Or even anion gap may be low also. So in case where proteins are increased, hyperproteinemia or even multiple myeloma, okay, where proteins level are increased, so anions are increased, so the ratio where is 10 to 12, it may be decreased. So this is all about the acidosis, alkalosis, and anion gap. I hope you understand the basic concept of this acid-base balance and you like this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share my video, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell icon so that you can get notification for my future video. Also, in my next video, I will be talking about the case discussion of the arterial blood gas analysis. Thank you for watching. Bye.